The online community wasn't very helpful. That was to
yes,
say
they are rough. At times.
They were quite rough to me. Yeah. It's like, hey, I'm just a noob here. I'm just trying a little bit here.
Help me out here.
Help me out.
Press all that four.
Hey guys, welcome back to another Hunchback React, and we are back with Sander van Zanten.
Hello, Paul. Thanks for having me.
Of course. If you may know, Sander did the soundtrack for Deliver Us the Moon. Also did a lot of great trailer tracks for our albums. What kind of really pulled you into this world of visual and audio?
Visual and audio. So it's, I guess it all comes down to stories, right? Yeah. To making people feel things that they wouldn't necessarily experience on a daily basis. No, really just that, making people feel things.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's interesting because like if I'm writing for just in random, so a lot of electronic music I made in the past, you kind of write it into nothingness. That's kind of a language you're just throwing into the universe, throwing into like a black hole of thoughts. But then when you write to image, so it can be film or it can be game, you already have a little bit of a baseline to go from.
Yeah.
How do you feel that? How do you fill that in for yourself?
Well, this for me, music has a very supporting role to play here. So when you write music to a particular scene, and this could be like an acting scene, but also an environmental scene, there is, I think the job of the composer there is to amplify or support whatever emotion the director or the writer or the environment artist want players or viewers to feel, right? So the music is there to amplify what is already actually in the scene, but can be brought out stronger through music, and that's, I think, a very beautiful thing.
Yeah, no, it's interesting because if we think about film and we are filming just humans acting, then you have a certain role. But yes, if you make a game and you model everything, you're kind of, trying to make an actor from scratch.
Yeah.
And if you do animation, you kind of do the same thing. You reinvent the way we interact with one another. So I think music can play a very big role in also getting those emotions out because you have, we are very used to humans interacting with one
Absolutely.
Another.
Yeah.
And again, like when you remake a human in animation, that's also a little bit different. So we need to emphasize that with something else.
Yeah. I mean, creating an animated character, you choose what you want to show there. So in a way, it's like a human character, only the actor is the creator of the animated character.
Yeah.
If that makes sense. So whatever the animator feels like, okay, this is what should happen here, then also is portrayed on the animated character itself. And our job as composers is to help them convey the message that they intended with whatever the character is doing.
So do you like to write, and it of course depends completely on a project, but maybe you have a preference to like to make the music the feeling of the character that you portray, or do you want it to more the feeling the audience should have?
I think composers should be careful in steering emotions.
Hmm.
So usually I
suggest.
yeah, you could suggest. You can use it for dramatic effect. In that case, it's cool to steer. But when you do it too much, where the scene already actually contains it, then I feel it's better to be more subtle and just reflect what's already happening in the scene and don't try to, you know, let the music take center stage.
Yeah.
It's not about the music. The music is one contributing factor to the overall scene, but it should never take front and center,
yeah.
I think. Unless that is the purpose of the work.
Yeah,
that's fine too.
It's interesting. I think we actually should do a longer podcast on kind of how to fill in these gaps of emotions.
We should.
But we're here to react on the trailer. You brought another favorite.
I did, yeah. I've been watching this incredible new animated show on Netflix, Arcane, which is based on the League of Legends universe created by Riot. And I, as I was watching it, I was struck by how incredible it is in nearly every way. It is, the writing is great, the characters are great, the visual style is awesome, and the music, they always just knock it out of the park.
I heard that this took a long time to create this show.
A long time.
I haven't seen it myself. I did see some trailers in the past. I'm not sure if I've seen this one.
Right. Yeah.
Shall we just dive into
Let's
it
dive
and
in.
See what we think? Arcane.
Here we go.
Oof. Starting with an alarm right away.
As a kid, me and my sister.
There's a bit of dread in here.
We pretended to chase monsters away.
Chase monsters. Okay. Some good hits there.
Got some damage in there.
This style is really next level.
Monster's gonna get you and I'm here.
It's 2.5D animation.
I don't think I've ever seen that anywhere.
I have to find her.
All right. Beautiful Blade Runner-ish vibe there, huh?
Yeah. Very dystopian here.
Up there on the surface.
I like the sound as well.
Yeah.
Dramatic.
Topsiders are leaving.
I like drama.
The synthesized brass.
I believe I've discovered something incredible.
Wow. It's really good.
We can harness magic through science.
You don't understand what's at stake.
Wow. They sync it up so nicely as well.
Sound design as well.
So good.
It comes to those.
You felt even the weight of the shoes.
Yeah.
To achieve it. Imagining yourself a hero. Then what are you waiting for?
And the lighting also, man. The broken.
Yeah.
More lives may be
ooh,
lost.
The cinematography is so good.
Cannot be controlled.
Wow, I definitely have to see this.
Yeah.
Then we have to go.
Just like every
force.
Moment has been thought out so well.
The drums are going wild.
Here we go. Building up.
Ooh, yeah, that sync up with the sound.
Yeah.
Ooh,
yeah.
Beautiful.
The cycle of violence will never stop.
That was an interesting bit, right? Because she slammed the other character into the wall, but at the same time, we immediately cut to an explosion further up ahead.
You've got a good heart.
Kind of used the sync point for two different visual events happening.
Protect the family.
Man, it does get me hyped for this. Oh, the monkey face.
Are we still sisters? Nothing.
But that feels real almost, animation.
Yeah.
Oh. Wow, okay. That was some anime influences there, definitely.
Yeah, there's a lot of that in there.
Oof.
All the action scenes in there, they're just next level.
Arcane League of Legends. Wow, I definitely have to see this one. I think the music is bombastic, but then also you have these sync moments where they use the hits, but then also the sound design effects to sync it up, where it's like click clack rhythmicking.
It all comes together. Yeah, the music, the sound design, the visuals. It's very there's a very elegant choreography to this by getting everything together, making it. There's something magical that happens when everything just clicks at the right moment.
Yeah.
You get the feeling of momentum. It drives you forward. There's a groove to it. It just works very well.
I think it's what you're supposed to do with a trailer. You need to get people on the edge of the seat. And we actually came a little bit forward while we were watching it. So I think that's what you want. You were like, wow, what's happening? I want to see this. I want to buy a ticket. I want to play the game. If you do that, if you hype people up, I think that's what you kind of want. That's also
works,
the art of a trailer.
Yeah. No, this is just a super successful trailer in my eyes.
Yeah.
It just works so well creatively. It got me hyped for a game I haven't touched in a long time. And it isn't even a trailer for the game. It's just a trailer for a universe in which that game takes place.
And I find it interesting because you see it happening way more. So, of course, with The Witcher, you see, hey, it becomes multimedium. So it's not only a game. Of course, you have merchandise. It's not only their own channel and maybe the developer having their own channels, but it's also going from film to games to film, to books to, and I really like that.
Absolutely, yeah. Riot is doing all these different interesting things now. We all know them from League of Legends, of course, which is has been their main thing for so many years.
Yeah.
But over the past few years, they've started to expand into new territory, primarily still, of course, in games. So we've seen new games as Legends of Runeterra. We've seen Valorant, for example.
I remember actually me trying League of Legends, and it's a quite steep learning curve to go into the game. The online community wasn't very helpful.
They are rough at times.
They were quite rough to me. It's like, hey, I'm just a noob here. I'm just trying a little bit here.
Help me out here.
Help me out.
Press all that four.
No, but it's amazing. I think that this, if you get over the learning curve, games like this are amazing. It's full.
Oh yeah. Have you ever been to the live championships?
that I've never been myself, but I have seen it, which is insane, because I know back in the day when we were gaming competitively, it was kind of like a fun thing and maybe a leaderboard online somewhere.
Yeah.
Now the stadium is filled with people, and
it's incredible. Yeah, the
times have changed.
It's such a big show in there, and League of Legends, they do the esports thing so cool. The events, they're just awesome.
It's insane how these things change. But then again, I never know that this was in the making while League of Legends was just doing their thing. This was, for me, it came a little bit out of nowhere. But then I heard that this was in development for, I'm not sure if I'm right, but it was like 9 years or something to create something like this.
That's a long time.
That's, but then again, like, it looks gorgeous. So who am I to say that you don't need that time?
Who knows? Yeah, well, it has a bit of a timeless look, right? Which is one of the interesting things about choosing a stylized look. If you pursue a very realistic approach to the thing that you're creating, you risk becoming outdated at some point because technology advances, we get better at approaching reality. But, you know, using a style like this, it's very stylized. It doesn't really age because it doesn't try to approach how things look photorealistically.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
So it can go, like, maybe we watch this in 30 years from now and we're still like, oh, that's amazing.
It'll still be cool. Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Very interesting. Arcane. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch
it. Go watch it.
You already watched the whole thing?
I did, and I'm super stoked for season two. Is there going to be a season two? I hope there will be. I imagine there will be because
it's successful.
There has to be.
They must push it.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Is it open ending a little bit? Like, does it leave you hanging, or is it conclusive to some extent?
It ties off enough strings, but it leaves room for more to come.
Interesting.
Yeah, go check it out. It's the best.
Awesome. No, thanks for bringing this one. I thought it was amazing. I got hyped for it, so I'm definitely gonna watch it. For you guys, if you like it as well, make sure to like the video. Make sure to subscribe. Also, if you have any suggestions, please leave it down in the comments. For now, I want to wish you the best and see you next time.
Have a good one.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. If you like it, make sure to check our other suggestions. Also, if you want to support us, make sure to hit the logo and subscribe.